Before the internet and flight tracking apps, if you wanted to know what kind of plane was flying overhead, you had to bust out a pair of these. Or if you were really prepared, head to your city's airport with this. With the advent of the myriad of flight tracking applications available at our fingertips, it's now possible to see not only the aircraft type that's flying over, but its operator, origin and destination, altitude, speed, and crucially, its position. Much of the time, the flight paths are routine. Flights depart and head off in the direction of the destination. But sometimes aircraft are shown flying in patterns or making seemingly unexplained movements. Today, we'll take a look at why aircraft sometimes fly in strange ways. Let's answer the question, what is this plane doing? We'll start with a simple one. Sometimes, especially at peak periods of arrivals, you'll see aircraft begin to fly in circles, or more accurately, a shape called a stadium, but which is usually referred to in this context as a racetrack. This is called a holding pattern. Unlike a car or a boat, a fixed-wing aircraft can't stop moving through the air, or it would lose the lift that keeps it flying. So air traffic controllers instruct pilots to enter holding patterns at designated locations, known as fixes, while they wait for their turn to use the runway. Delays may be caused by inbound traffic congestion, poor weather, or runway unavailability. As such, holding patterns are more likely to be employed during peak arrival times at larger airports. Several aircraft may fly in the same holding pattern simultaneously, separated vertically. This is called a stack. London Heathrow, for example, has four main arrival stacks where inbound aircraft are held and funneled down before being cleared to approach a runway. But what about when planes are flying in what look like holding patterns, but close to the ground and on top of the airport? This is called a traffic pattern, or circuit, depending on where in the world you're flying. A circuit is a standard path used for coordinating air traffic while maintaining visual contact with the airfield. The circuit allows pilots to know where other aircraft are likely to be, and the consistent, predictable pattern allows for much greater situational awareness for pilots. Circuit training is often the first stage of practical pilot training, as it allows new pilots to focus on the fundamentals of flying, and as such, you're more likely to see smaller aircraft flying circuits at regional and general aviation airports and at military airbases. In cases where two or more parallel runways are in operation concurrently, you may see contra-rotating patterns to ensure maximum separation between aircraft in the patterns. For the next scenario, we need to briefly discuss how flight tracking works. Contemporary flight tracking applications rely on volunteer-provided ADS-B data to monitor information about nearby aircraft. ADS-B data may include many parameters, including flight identification, ICAO 24-bit aircraft address, position, altitude, vertical speed, track angle, and ground speed. Aircraft periodically broadcast this data, allowing them to be tracked. Because the data is broadcast at set intervals without the need for a prompt or interrogation, the data can be picked up by air traffic controllers, other aircraft, which allows aircraft to be visible to each other on flight deck instruments and can be integrated with collision avoidance systems, as well as anyone on the ground with a receiver. Most flight tracking apps, however, don't need the granularity of data required by air traffic service providers. While ADS-B equipment broadcasts signals approximately every half second, online flight trackers only need a fraction of that data to provide a relatively accurate depiction of air traffic. This filtering can lead to errors in data, jumps in position, altitude, or speed caused by insufficient or erroneous data. A few seconds is all that should be required for the aircraft to update back to its actual position. Sometimes you'll spot smaller general aviation aircraft flying in rows, parallel lines capped by 180-degree turns and almost always north-south or east-west lines. These aircraft are performing aerial surveys and capturing data for a wide variety of clients and uses. Aerial surveys can provide improved results over satellite imagery, as they can offer higher resolution imagery and are impacted less by atmospheric conditions such as high-level cloud or haze. One of the more prominent and easily accessible results of aerial surveys is Google's 3D city imagery. Using 45-degree angled photographs captured from planes, images from different directions are compiled into a mesh, allowing almost all objects to be captured in 3D. Governments also use aerial surveys to gather large amounts of information for historical, planning, research, and geoscience purposes. There are many and varied uses for aerial survey imagery, which is why these aircraft are so frequently seen flying over major cities. When ground equipment at or near airports is installed, upgraded, or serviced, you might see aircraft flying around over the course of several days to test the equipment. When you observe aircraft flying in circles around an airport, they are likely testing a navigational aid, or NAVAID, by ensuring that the distance and course provided by the NAVAID are correctly calibrated. You might also observe aircraft testing the instrument landing system, or ILS, by repeatedly flying approaches to the runway and making arcs through the ILS beams. This is to ensure that both the localizer and glide slope portions of the ILS hardware are calibrated and functioning as expected. Some aircraft are blocked on flight trackers. You may see or hear an aircraft flying overhead, but find that it doesn't appear on your favorite app. For security and privacy reasons, information about some aircraft is limited or blocked. This includes most military aircraft and certain high-profile aircraft, like Air Force One. The owner or operator may also elect to have their aircraft blocked on online flight trackers. For example, operators of private jets may block their aircraft from tracking to preserve the privacy of their clients. You may also find that some aircraft may appear on some services but not others. For example, while many military aircraft do not appear on larger, global trackers, they may appear on smaller, more localized providers of ADS-B data. Occasionally, you might see flights taking unusually roundabout or seemingly excessively long routes between their origin and destination. If you're watching live, some sites allow you to turn on weather overlays, and this will likely reveal the cause of the strange routes. While aircraft can usually fly through bad weather safely, most commercial aircraft have been struck by lightning at some point while in service, it can present undesirable side effects, such as turbulence, icing, poor visibility, and wind shear. So pilots, in coordination with air traffic control, will often attempt to avoid poor weather where possible, even if that means flying a less economical or direct route. Weather need not be directly in an aircraft's path to impact its route. If an aircraft's destination is congested or affected by poor weather, air traffic controllers may vector aircraft off their airway to extend their travel distance and thus reduce time spent in a holding pattern near the destination. Finally, let's talk about flight tests. You may have seen aircraft taking off from and arriving back into the same airport, and there are particular airports which see this kind of traffic fairly frequently. Aircraft require flight testing at various stages of their operational life, before new aircraft are delivered to the customer, when aircraft are being transferred to a new owner, or after heavy maintenance has been performed, for example. You might see flights take off and then fly in holding patterns at various altitudes, or occasionally you might see sky art. Often when new aircraft types are being tested, flight planners plot a route which draws a picture when viewed on flight trackers. The aircraft has to be flown for testing, so why not get some free advertising while you're at it? So hopefully this gives you a little more insight into why planes and their pilots might be flying the way they are. And next time someone asks, "What is this plane doing?" you'll know exactly what it is and why they're doing it. If you enjoyed this video, you can check out more like it in the education playlist. And if you'd like to help me produce more videos, check out my Patreon in the description.